I must say, I recommend it.
Just go and see the world and just show them what it really means to live life golden. Yeah, we're golden, baby girl, we're golden. They're about to see it shine, cause we're golden. They can't ever break us down, cause we're golden.
Whoa. Welcome everybody, I'm RJ of the Nerdy Brew, and here on this channel we talk TV, movies, and everything in between, all while drinking a cup of coffee. And if you like one of those things, or all of those things, why don't you consider like, subscribing, and hit that notification bell, and becoming a fellow Brewster. In today's video, we are reviewing The LoveBirds.
The movie stars Issa Rae, Kumail Nanjiani, and Paul Sparks, Mickey Doyle, directed by Michael Showalter.
So, the premise of the movie is that Issa Rae and Kumail Nanjiani are in a long-term relationship, and they end up having an impasse where they have a conflict of how they're going to move forward, knowing that their relationship has problems or it has reached the plateau. On their way to an event, as a couple with these issues, they get involved in a murder. And with being involved in the murder, they end up getting caught up in the case, trying to clear their name, trying to solve the plot behind the murder, the reasons to it, and also clear their name. And while the movie goes along, it's them also trying to find a resolution within their relationship. So that's the plot. And overall, I really enjoyed this movie. The first thing that I really loved about this movie is that it started off with Snow Allegra. And when they started off playing off with Snow Allegra, it made me think like, oh, this is the vibe. Like, this movie's up on game. Like, they know what's up. And the movie starts off very sincere of puppy dog love and how those butterflies and just the infatuation with somebody just shows the magnetism and attraction that you just want to spend your time with this person. And I'm trying to spoil the movie. Maybe I should say minor spoilers, but after a long time, they get to know each other and know their quirks, and they have like a dynamic of people who just know each other over time, that's been with each other day in, day out. So the flaws start to be a big irritant instead of just acceptance. And the thing that made it so believable and enjoyable was that Kumail Nanjiani and Issa Rae had a very good relationship and very good chemistry. What also popped about the chemistry is that the dialogue between them was so sharp, so honest, so authentic. They had a lot of mundane conversations that when you just get to a tipping point of what of a long-term relationship, what else is there to say? So they have the most like monotonous conversations that are just basically what a conversations that you would have with your friends, which would be pointless, that would go nowhere, but at the same time it was a matter of them, and it was very humorous and very engaging between them that made me enjoy watching it. The thing about the premise of the movie is that there are other movies just like it, the movie Date Night, the movie Murder Mystery. It all had similar beats where you have an unbecoming couple that were very average. They have things going for themselves, but it wasn't like they were like the upper echelon of like society and, you know, twists and turns. Do they get involved with that? Yes, but is that them as people? No. And with that being said, with them not being that kind of dynamic, make the plot very formulaic. Like, but the thing that was a highlight, and once again I'm bringing it up, is their chemistry. How the movie plays out is that even though that they know that they came to a tipping point and their relationship. Excuse me, I'm going to take a sip of my coffee because it's what this channel is about. And even when they get to a tipping point of their relationship, the situation allows them to grow and get to know each other once again, because everything that they're going through is a once-in-a-lifetime experience, and it's just like following through of not just them trying to solve the plot of the film, but solve their internal conflict as characters, which made it very sharp, very enlightening, you know? Is that enlightening strikes? No. You know, sometimes I'll just be recording and going, but anywho. Yeah, it just made it very engaging for them and relatable when you go through a relationship and you don't know how things are gonna play out of moving forward or separating. And the thing that really made it go along is all the hijinks within the movie. Yeah, there's twists and turns. Once again, the movie was very humorous. I would say, you know, I could watch the movie again on my own time. It's not a background movie. It's a very deliberate choice movie when you're done with the day and you want to give yourself a nice little bit of escapism with humor. This movie, all in all, was very, very good. It was supposed to have a theater debut, but that didn't happen due to the world. Not any other reason but the world, Craig. The world. And since the circumstances are like that, it was very nice for me to just see it on streaming. And it was good, though, for a date. It was good for a date because it also has good, how you say? Yo, that was totally racist, bro. But it's more like conversation talk. Conversation talk of, you know, how that made you feel about the movie. But I'm going to bring this video to an end, so I'm going to grade the 7.1. And I hope you enjoy it. Let me know in the comments below, did you dig on this movie? Just tell me your thoughts about the movie. Have you seen it? Do you like it? Are you liking and subscribing and becoming a fellow Brewster and how we have these informal conversations about the things we like? But I'm gonna bring this video to an end. And I want you to be you, do you, see the bigger picture, have a fantastic day, because you deserve it. This is that channel. Peace.